the treatment. Ridding your body of the poisonous toxins built up over time by a lifetime of negativity. Day 1. Putting yourself to a detox. If you're still with me, it means you have concluded that you are poisoned and are willing to try this 3-day process. Congratulations. Even though you're poisoned with negativity, we can treat your condition like any other illness. Imagine that you have just arrived at a hospital and have been diagnosed as poisoned. We need to start your treatment right away. It won't take long. By the end of the day, you will be treated, ready to begin tomorrow's rehab work. Detox, ridding your mind and body of poison. Detox is usually the first step in any rehab program. If someone is committed to a clinic for alcoholism, the first thing the clinic focuses on is getting the alcohol out of the patient's body. Only after the patient's body is free of alcohol can the rehab process begin. The same goes for any poison. The first priority is to get rid of the poison. Only then can we start the work on preventing becoming poisoned again. Negativity is a mind poison, so the first step in the process of ridding yourself of it completely is to undergo a massive detox of your mind. Detox your mind. Your physical ailments due to excessive exposure to negativity, typically stiffness in your neck, an aching body, back pain, or excessive sweating, but hopefully no serious diseases yet, will ideally heal by themselves once you have cleansed your mind. For me, this was my breakthrough, that my mind would heal itself if I just gave it a chance. Let's begin the detox. Each of the 4 steps only takes a few minutes to complete, then you will have the rest of the day to reflect on your answers. Step 1. Confront yourself. The first thing you have to do is to realize and accept that you are infected and poisoned by negativity. This is an extremely powerful thing to do that triggers your self-preservation force to its highest level. Later we will use this force, your instinct to survive, to push the poison out of the body. Confront yourself right now. Find a place where you can be alone and ask yourself each of the questions with your eyes closed. Answer truthfully. This could change your life. Are you poisoning yourself with negative thoughts? Yes or no? Do you accept that you are responsible for poisoning yourself? Yes or no? Are you ready to stop self-destructing and take control? Yes or no? Admit that you are poisoned and make a decision. That's it. If you're serious about escaping the negativity in your life, you will not self-destruct anymore. You will take control from here on and guard your mind from poisonous thoughts and feelings. Step 2. Toss out your negative issues. Now we'll collect and throw out all your negative thoughts, feelings, issues and baggage once and for all. We will do it right now. Imagine that you are a smoker and you are diagnosed with cancer. Your immediate action should be to stop smoking right there and then. This would be the moment when your motivation to stop smoking is at its peak. The same should be true for your motivation to throw out negativity. Your discovery that you are poisoned should really put you in a state of shock. You should want to do something drastic to rid yourself of the poison festering inside you, right now. You do not want to make yourself sick. You do not want to continue blaming someone or something outside yourself for stuff that is your responsibility. You do not want to indulge in dangerous negative thoughts and feelings anymore. You cannot risk this tricky poison getting the better of you anymore. Choose to fight the negativity. Whether the poisonous negative thoughts and feelings originate with you or are triggered by someone or something, how you choose to react to them is 100% your responsibility and yours alone. You see, if you do not choose to fight and reject the poison, it will eat you alive. You will continue to poison yourself with negativity with no idea of the consequences. The constant influx of negative energy can create serious illness in your body, such as hypertension or ulcers, or even cancer. Studies overwhelmingly show that a negative mind leads to a weakened immune system, giving you far less ability to withstand disease. So if you want to be healthy, stay positive. Throw out the poison or you will certainly ruin your chances for living a happy life, fulfilling your dreams and accomplishing your purpose. List your own negative issues. Write down issues that bother you on a daily basis, either on a piece of paper or use the app. Write down stuff that keeps you awake at night, stuff from your nightmares, anything you find annoying, everyone and everything that makes you angry, everything you worry about. Write it all down now. On top of the page you write, my sack of poison. I throw in my anger for, write down what comes to mind. I throw in my fear of, write down what comes to mind. I throw in my worry about. I throw in my hate for. I throw in every negative thing from the past. We really recommend you to use the app. Now, look, this next bit is really important and is only going to work if you are really paying attention. So pay attention here. Take a deep breath and settle your mind. Relax any tension in your body. Read through your list again, then close your eyes and imagine that you have a large sack with a big poison sign on it. Imagine filling the sack with all your negative issues. Keep going until you feel completely empty. Now, close the sack with a rope and knot it tightly. Imagine you're standing on the edge of a tall cliff. Say to yourself, I refuse to carry this shit around anymore. It hurts me. It wears me out. It ties me down. It makes me depressed and unhappy. I will let everything go. I will throw it out of my life now. If you use the app, I have recorded this for you. If you prefer to listen to it instead of remembering while imagining, you will find the soundtrack under Sound Files. Throw the sack off the cliff, over the edge and onto the rocks below. Watch it spin away under you into the depths, where it can never hurt you again. Just like that, your negativity is gone. Feel relieved. Feel the weight lifting from your shoulders. Feel the freedom. Feel that you have a new beginning, that you have left all the negativity behind. Doesn't it feel good? If you use the app, I've recorded this exercise for you, if you prefer to listen to it instead of remembering while imagining. You will find the soundtrack under Sound Files in the app. Step 3. Forgive and let go. In the last step, we threw out a lot of negativity in one go, and we lightened our negativity load significantly in the process. But some tricky negative emotions can require a bit of extra focused work if you find yourself under their attack. Specifically, those emotions dealing directly with other people's influences. These negative thoughts and feelings may be linked to specific persons in your life or from your past. These negative thoughts and feelings are usually bitterness, grudges, hatred and envy, or jealousy. These are the most insidious of the negative poisons. They can cling to you tightly, even when you try to let them go. But there is an effective way to get them out of your system in an instant, leaving you free to redesign your life until it's just the way you want it to be. With this very important step, you will finally stop living your life according to what people around you dictate. You will stop living your life according to your parents, or according to your partner, or according to your boss. This very important step in the detox process will set you free, free to redesign your life as you want. This important step is forgive and let go. Forgiveness means letting go. Bitterness, hatred, grudges, envy, and jealousy eat away at us from the inside. For our own good, for our own health and well-being, we have to let them go. Forget about fairness. Forget that you've been cheated. You can't do anything about it anyway. It's in the past. Let it go. This is not about anyone else. This is about you. I'm not saying that you should approve of whatever this person did to hurt you. You don't have to approve to let it go. This is about you making a decision to stop poisoning yourself with your own negative thoughts and feelings of bitterness, grudges, hatred, and revenge. This is about you doing what it takes to stop hurting yourself. Letting go means relinquishing control. If you have been trying to control others, if others have disappointed you immensely, if you have tried to change others, if you have tried to catch others in making mistakes, if you have been suspicious of persons closest to you, you may have felt a massive disappointment initially, only to let the feeling turn into bitterness or even worse, hatred. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but you cannot control another person. You cannot change another person, and you shouldn't attempt to do so. In addition to this being an exhausting, impossible task that will only drive you mad, trying to control another person actually means giving them total control over you. Their every move will affect you. Whenever they do something you don't approve of, they trigger your negativity. Hence, they control your doses of poison. You have to let it go. And you have to do it now. Sometimes letting go means saying goodbye. What does it mean to let go? Does it mean to let go of the hurt or the person? I think the answer depends on whether the person is in your life or out of your life. If the person is out of your life and it's an old grudge, when you let it go, both the hurt and the person are gone. If the person you want to forgive is still in your life, you also have to decide if you want to keep that person in your life. In most cases, I think you do. But in other cases, it might be time for you to let go and move on, saying goodbye to the person who has hurt you. This can be difficult because the person who hurt you may cling to your life. But by allowing the person to remain in your life, there is a high likelihood that they will hurt you again in the future. For example, you might be in a relationship where one is trying to build a relationship, but the other is behaving as he or she is single. In this case, one partner provides the security of being a relationship and most likely gives a lot of love, usually because he is blinded by love, while the other person reaps the benefits but does not give anything in return. This relationship is totally off balance, and it may be better for the person who only gives but does not receive to let the other person go. How? The process is the same as it is for a person not in your life. Forgive, wish well, and let go of hurt. But in addition, you have the option to either 1. Say goodbye and step out of the person's life, or demand a balance in the relationship, quid pro quo. A special person to forgive. Before we start the process of forgiving and letting go, I want to talk to you about a very special person you also have to address. That person is you. Yes, you may have hurt yourself. When we are poisoned, we can reach the point where we start to self-destruct. We begin to blame everyone and everything for our unhappiness and misfortune. Our deceptive, poisonous minds start giving us dangerous ideas. What if I did some harm too? That'll teach them. Let's do what those who hurt me do, so they can taste their own medicine. If you have ever indulged in such thoughts, you may have managed to keep them in check when conscious. However, many who are poisoned try to ease their sorrows by drinking too much, using drugs, or in some way losing or inhibiting their judgment. If you have self-destructed like this, consciously or unconsciously, you know that eventually it tends to backfire. As we talked about earlier, life can change in a split second. You can change your life in a split second. Self-destruction is just that. You changing your life for the worse in a split second. Just as you forgive other people who have hurt you, you also have to forgive yourself so you can let any past self-destruction episodes go. Do it now. Forgive and let go. Let's let go of any hurt and forgive any person who hurts you. Let's let go and forgive any person who doesn't do what you want them to do if you could control them. Let's let go and forgive any person you hold a grudge against, are bitter toward, or hate, even if they will continue to be in your life. You have no choice in this matter. You need to do this as part of the detox process. There is no getting around it. You need to release the hold these negative feelings have over you. Trust me on this. If you wholeheartedly forgive any and every person that has hurt you, magic will happen. If they are still in your life, they will probably either miraculously change their ways or disappear from your life. At the very least, they will instantly lose their hold over you. Think about the person or persons who currently bothers you so much they keep you awake at night or make you tense and worried. Use the app or write on a piece of paper the name or names of the person or persons you feel negative about. If you use the app, I have recorded this for you so you can listen to it instead of remembering it while imagining, and you will again find the soundtrack under sound files. Now, sit down in a quiet place, close your eyes and imagine that the first person on your list is right there in front of you. Say mentally, I forgive you for having hurt me. And I forgive you if you hurt me again. I release you of any feelings of bitterness, grudges, hatred, or revenge. I wish you all the best for your life. Smile and see the person smiling back. Then repeat with every person on your list. Finish by imagining yourself in front of a mirror. Say to yourself, I forgive myself for all my past and future mistakes. I forgive myself if I have self-destructed in the past, and I let it go. I wish me all the best for my life. Smile into the mirror in front of you and see yourself smiling back. Open your eyes and feel the relief. Feel the weight lifted from your shoulders, like you've been carrying a heavy backpack and finally put it down. You should feel the strangest thing happening. The persons you forgave will lose whatever hold they once had over you. Even if they have been the focus of your negativity for decades, they will lose their hold on you the instant you forgive them. And if necessary, let that go. Your life will change for the better in a split second when you forgive someone you were previously unwilling to forgive, creating lasting change for the better. You will feel free. Step 4. Lock your door to negativity. In today's society, even some of our largest and most established entities feed on negativity. You have to carefully filter this negativity out because it feeds on itself. Negativity attracts more negativity. Religion. Whether or not you are religious yourself, you may have observed that religion focuses on many negative feelings like fear, regret, and guilt. In many religions, one basic concept is that there is a good power and a bad power. The good power is constantly fighting the bad power. It is important to bear in mind that these texts were written in ancient times when mankind had a very different worldview. For example, back then, it was commonly thought that the earth was flat. The texts have been interpreted, rewritten, and translated many times. Could it be that some of the focus on negativity is also outdated? Or maybe those who wrote the religious scriptures just got it wrong when they wrote it down? Perhaps they even infused their translations with their own human negativity. The world has really changed in the last few hundred years, especially with respect to technology and communication. I think it's only fair to ask yourself if some of the negative parts of your religions are outdated. Here is another potentially shocking idea you may not have considered. What if there is no bad force? What if there is just force? Nobody really knows the truth. From early childhood, we are indoctrinated with the idea that someone knows and there is a right answer to everything, when in reality, nothing could be further from the truth. Depending on where we grow up and what society we come from, we are indoctrinated to believe that there is only one right way to live. But this is not true. What we do know from our history is that people who claim they know the right way are usually wrong. Many of our establishments are often wrong, while many of the people who discover some of our universe's secrets are ridiculed and even locked up. Galileo Galilei, who figured out the earth was round, was deemed a heretic and put in house arrest by the Pope himself. In fact, some of our most beloved inventions come from ideas critics who know better insisted would never work. I include a few of my favorite "it will never work" quotes from modern times. About the car. The extraordinary, Horseless carriage is at present a luxury for the wealthy, and although its price will probably fall in the future, it will never, of course, come into as common use as the bicycle. That was in Literary Digest, 1899. About the computer. There is no reason for any individual to have a computer in their home. Kenneth Olson, president and founder of Digital Equipment Corporation, 1977. About radio transmission.
Radio has no future.
Lord Kelvin, 1824. I include the above examples to show you that no one really knows the answers, especially to existential questions like what happens when we are born and die and how life started on this planet. Nobody knows exactly how it all works yet. No one knows how our solar system truly connects to the billions of other solar systems in our universe, or, for that matter, the seemingly endless cosmos beyond. And you know what? That's okay. Embrace the mystery and enjoy the journey. I was so lucky in my teens, a wise man told me, if you do the best you can, and if you try to make things right when you fail, and continue to do the best you can, then no one in this world or any other world can ever judge you. Believe in the universe. Believe in the incredible force that keeps these enormous planets from colliding. Whether you attribute that force to gravity or some other invisible power, know that now that mankind is preparing to inhabit Mars and we have sent rockets to our next solar system, it's pretty obvious to me there is a force. It's also obvious to me that this force or forces is available for us to master and use to our benefit. The cool thing is that I don't need to know how these forces work in order to reap their benefits. Let's use electricity as an example. If you put your head against a high-voltage electric cable, you're dead. However, the same electricity charges your smartphone. Is electricity evil when it kills you and kind when it charges your phone? It's neither. It's simply an incredible force. One which we manage to use for a lot of nice stuff, like heating, charging, driving, and lightning. Even though we know incredibly little about the universe we live in, we know that there is a force called gravity. Gravity pulls us down so we don't fall off Earth.
Fall off Earth? That's silly, you may think.
Yet, remember, the Earth is at this very moment traveling around the Sun at a speed of 69,000 miles per hour. And so are seven more planets, plus moons and dwarf planets, that may number in the hundreds. It's not my mission to tell you what to believe. My mission is to tell you to remove negativity from your life so that you can become more positive. If you choose to believe there is some old fellows with a long beard up there running the show, keeping everything in our colossal universe from colliding while at the same time judging and punishing your every action, be my guest. But you'll make it very difficult for yourself to stay on the positive side, since you open yourself up to so much associated negativity. I only ask you to question any dictate or directive that leads you to indulge in negative thoughts and feelings like guilt or punishment. Negative thoughts and feelings are bad for you, wherever they originate. Ultimately, nobody really knows, so make up your own mind. Other daily influences. Right alongside religion, you have thousands of alternative cults and political isms to pick and choose from. However, many of these also feed on people's negative feelings, like fear of lacking, sense of injustice, or xenophobia. To speed things up, these negative feelings have plenty of help from the media, which plays on whoever has the most fear to offer. Bad news sells more than good news. War sells news. Terror sells news. But it doesn't stop there. Even large corporations play on your fear. They advertise poison. They advertise negativity.
Feel a cold, take this pill.
It's said that in medieval times, when a plague hit a society, more people died from fear of the plague than from the plague itself. Could it be that people get a cold because advertisements are constantly reminding them to check for one? After meeting someone, you will either feel lifted or exhausted. That is because some people give you energy and some people drain your energy. They may not intend to do this. It just depends on how poisoned they are themselves. Most people love to share their opinions, and they usually have opinions about everything. They believe opinions reflect their know-how. Whenever you find yourself in contact with people who try to impose their negative opinions on you, just politely move away and, to the fullest extent possible, stay away from them or meet them armed to the teeth with positivity. Your own past. Perhaps the greatest source of negativity available to you is your past. If you have a negative past, professionals practically line up to dig into it. You may think you are special and very unfortunate when you think about your past. Sorry to break it to you, but you are not special at all. Bad things happen to a lot of people. I cannot explain why innocent children are hurt beyond words, but neither can anyone else. I believe that this is connected to so many people being poisoned with negativity. What I can tell you is that you will never free yourself from negativity and find happiness by obsessing over your negative past. Stop thinking and talking about your negative past. Close the door to your past completely. Lock it down, bolt it, and throw away the key, and don't let it affect your life any longer. Change the game and lock out all negativity. The final step of your detox process is to decide here and now that you will close the door to all negativity. For any lasting change to take hold, you really do need to want to change. So decide now that you will lock the door to negativity, you will bolt it tight and weld it closed so the negative influences can no longer reach you. This will be a total game changer for you. Again, in the app, this exercise we're going to do now is under Zone Files. Close your eyes and imagine you are in the basement of your home in front of a solid steel door. Imagine closing the door in the face of all the negative influences we've talked about earlier. Mentally say, "This is my door to negativity. I will now close it, lock it, bolt it, and throw away the key so that no one or nothing can break through." Open your eyes and feel the relief. Feel protected from future negativity. Now, congratulate yourself. You just made it through detox. Take the rest of the day off and enjoy your new positive outlook on life.